Kovchek presents. Like a curved bow, the horizon attracts travelers. The string of dream is drawn again, and the arrow of the expedition flies to faraway parts of the world. This time, it touches the land of Armenia. Mountain Armenia, the Kingdom of Bezoar. New project of the Ark Ecological Center on innovative description of the land led its team to Mountain Armenia. Here, researchers were going to penetrate into the world of primordial nature. Observe animals in their natural environment. The team of the Ark consisted of one of the well-known specialists on mountain ungulates, Pavel Weinberg. Field researcher and photographer Alexander Mohasyan, and geographer and cameraman Rodion Buchukuri. First of all, they were interested in the population of bezoar goats and the landscapes where they live. Work started in the beginning of winter. The first snow had thawed away already, and nothing hampered observations. Mature bezoar goat males, who live all year in smallish bachelor herds, started seeking females in order to mate and produce offspring. For Pavel Weinberg, it is an opportunity to understand their behavioral patterns, while Alexander Mohasyan will be able to enlarge his collection of fascinating photo shots. Soon new snow fell out and the frost set in. It is a signal for the bezoar goats to start mating. Males are very excited. All other troubles fade away, and the struggle for winning females' favor becomes the main aim. Males display their attention in a rather insistent manner. Younger males may be even importunate and do everything to reach their goal. Such observations provide Pavel with invaluable data. He has binoculars and spotting scope at his disposal, which shorten distance between him and the wild animals. However, this does not satisfy Alexander. For many years, he had been the coordinator of the program on leopards with the World Wildlife Fund Armenia. Obtained many unique shots of this very rare and secretive animal. This became possible thanks to photo traps. Radion suggested to go further and use not just photo, but video traps in order to insert the future material into the film. Upon an approval from the Armenian Office of the World Wildlife Fund, the project proceeded according to the plan. Next winter, the team arrived to the Khosrov Nature Reserve. Exactly there, on agreement with the administration of the reserve, it was decided to set up the video traps. This is not a simple task, requiring certain knowledge and skills. But when everything is done, one just has to go away and wait. In spaces of mountain Armenia, excited and inspired by curiosity and hopes, researchers dreamed to look into the mysteries of animal paths. After some time, just in case, the team decided to check the functioning of the video traps. It was a great disappointment. Something went wrong from the very start. One trap produced plain waste. It did hurt, because the material contained really unique footage, but was totally unuseful for the film. Other traps, for some unknown reason, functioned only by nights. Since dark time videos are only black and white and bad quality, they contained interesting scientific material, but were not usable for the film. Having changed the setups of the traps, the team had to leave again and immerse into doubts and tedious waiting for another half year. In the summer, it came time to return and check the results. Khosrov Nature Reserve transformed, having changed its severe winter image to a kaleidoscope of blue skies, white clouds, brown cliffs, and green foliage. Not expecting much, the team set off to check the traps. Alexander acquired the help of a young and energetic employee of the biological faculty of Yerevan State University, Manush Abramyan. The traps had been set up in different parts of the reserve, in gorges and ledges, so even just to visit them was a tiresome job. Then the footages had to be looked through, and only after that one could talk about the result. And there was a result. And some result it was. The plan worked, and it inspired the team. It managed to get footage that could not be obtained without the traps. Now, it was possible to watch a film shot by hidden cameras. Bezoar goat males reach 1.5 meter body length, 1 meter shoulder height, and can weigh up to 95 kilos. Both sexes have horns, much longer in males. Horns of females are slightly bent and some 20 to 39 centimeters long, while those of adult males are scimitar-shaped, with front keel and knobs at the borders of yearly segments. They may grow up to 130 centimeters and look very graceful. Mature males have silvery white pelage during the rut. Lower part of the muzzle and the beard are blackish brown. Black, interconnecting stripes run along the spine, the flanks, the throat, and the chest, and across the shoulders. After spring molt, the summer hairs are short and mainly sandy or fawn. Females and young are sandy or fawn all year round. Bezoar goats live in rather small herds of 7 to 10 animals, sometimes reaching 25 goats. Females and young animals live all year round in such groups, and females leave them only in order to give birth. Adult males spend most of the year in small bachelor groups of up to 4 to 5 animals. Bezoar goats feed on grasses, herbs, and leaves of trees and shrubs, but themselves in turn serve prey for leopards, lynxes, wolves, bears, and large birds of prey, like golden eagles and lammergeiers. It was possible to meet one of these predators, very secretive, only thanks to video traps. It's a lynx. Another predator, also present in mountain Armenia, and sharing one space with the bezoar goats, is the brown bear, whose population density is very high in the Khosrow Reserve due to protection. It is a forest dweller, performing seasonal migrations following appearance and thawing down of the snow cover. Males are solitary, while females form incomplete families with their offspring. Not just thanks to camera traps, but also in the course of field work, interesting encounters happened. While on his field trip, Alexander Malhasyan met with the gyrza, also known as Lebetina viper. Gyrza is a snake species of the genus of giant vipers. It is one of the most dangerous snakes. Its venom is inferior only to that of the cobra. Even experienced snake catchers happen to be victims of this snake. Alexander is also familiar with its venom, not on hearsay. This rendezvous, however, occurred while the snake was in the process of swallowing a young hare. It took quite some time. After having swallowed the prey, the snake was almost immobile, but after some time, decided to leave and hide. For the ARC team, it was also time to leave. Previously having set up video traps in other parts of the Khosrov Reserve in hope for new material. The final stage of the work occurred again in winter, the rutting period of the bezoar goats. Researchers chose Gnishik Nature Conservation Territory for observations. Huge gorge, cliff walls, ledges and precipices with grassy plots are typical habitat of bezoar goats. Thanks to protection, bezoar goat numbers are growing, and they are easy to observe. Bezoar goats are cliff dwellers. They are superior cliff climbers, negotiating almost vertical walls and narrow ledges, managing 3-meter jumps in case of need. When under threat, these animals do not run away across even terrain, but escape to the cliffs. The team really hoped to film a fight of rivaling males, which happens quite often during the rut. But this dream did not come true. All we could witness was a persistent and sometimes clumsy courtship. It was time to visit the camera traps again, and the team returned to Khosrov Reserve. In winter, because of snow and ice, it is much more difficult to reach the traps. Alexander changed the memory sticks and reloaded the traps. While Rodion started scanning the material. One trap provided a surprise. Having filmed, if not a fully fledged fight, then at least a small brawl between males. Another trap presented truly unique shots. Using the magic of video traps, remaining undetected observers in the world of superior hearing, eyesight, and sense of smell, the ARC team half opened a door into the mysterious life of animal paths of mountain Armenia.